The Electric Power Sector Reform Act of 2005 and the subsequent privatization of Nigeria's electricity sector in 2013 statutory saddled the electricity distribution companies the responsibility of providing meters to electricity customers and other electricity distribution infrastructure. The inability to provide meters to a significant number of residential consumers had resulted to alternative billing of unmetered customers on estimated billing based on methodology provided by NERC. The distribution companies and consumers have been at loggerheads over estimated billing due to absence of meters. Discos are optimistic the issue will be resolved with the introduction of meter assets provider. Chief Operating Officer of Ikeja Electric, Falake Shoeton, in a chat with TVC News, says the introduction of MAP will significantly bridge the gap.
The discos have not been able to close the metering gap for obvious reasons. And I believe that this scheme and initiative will ensure that all Nigerians have meters in their homes. There would be a survey that needs to be done of your location so that we can determine what you require. So if you require a single-phase meter or you require a three-phase meter, that survey will determine that. Once we determine that, you would then have to make payment for the meters. There's an approved cost that the regulator has given the discos. So if it's a single-phase meter, it's 38,000 naira, 850. If it is a three-phase meter, it is 70,000 naira, 350. And this is inclusive of VAT. Once you do that, once you make payment, you will be metered 10 days after you made payment into the account that you'll be advised once you complete that process I mentioned earlier on. So the meter asset provider gets to meter you once that payment is made, and they will do that within 10 days.
Mrs. Shoeton explained the modalities for accessing meter. She adds that the move will solve the problem of estimated billing by discos.
There are two options. You can either pay for the meter up front, but if you can't afford for the pay for the meter up front, there is opportunity for you to actually pay for that meter over a period, an extended period or an agreed period. Now, if your meter is going to, the cost of the meter is going to be spread over a period, every month you'll be required to make a down payment. That down payment on that meter that has been spread, that cost that has been spread over a period, is what we call the meter service charge. And this, like I said, is approved by the regulator. All you need to do, you register, you do your KYC, you sort out outstanding debt if you have any. A survey is done on your premises to determine what you require, whether it's a single phase or three phase. Once we determine that, the cost of the meter, which I mentioned earlier, will be given to you. That is all you're required to pay. That's all you'll be required to pay. You're not allowed to move your meter. If you are moving to another location, you will have to get in touch with the DISCO. In this case, which is the Ikeja Electric, you would advise them of the fact that you're changing addresses or you're moving to another location, and they will arrange to ensure that you are set up accordingly. Every account must have a meter. So if you have three accounts, so long as it's established that you have three accounts or you have more than one account, each account is entitled to a meter. Yes, you can. So you are one person, but you have, let's say, three apartments. Each apartment is an account, and each apartment is entitled to a meter. If you have a postpaid account, not a postpaid meter, so every customer that is hooked up to Ikeja Electric has an account. So you either have a postpaid meter, or you don't have a meter but you get an estimated bill, or you have a prepaid meter. Now, if you have an estimated bill, which means that either your meter is not functional or you don't have a meter at all, like I said, during your KYC, once you do your complete your KYC online, your outstanding on that account will show, once you complete the KYC section, that shows your outstanding. You would have cleared everything to do with your outstanding on the, on your account before you then go and pay for a meter. You won't be able to even pay for a meter if you've not settled all the outstanding issues. So if, for example, you have an outstanding amount that you have not paid, all that has to be sorted out before you then pay for this new meter. Once you are paying for this new meter and it's installed, and you are commissioned, you are good to go. You won't need to have this issue at this point, because you'd have already sorted out that issue before the meter is already placed on the wall. Know that this will bridge the gap. The discos are very excited. The Nigerian customer, the Nigerian public wants to be able to trust the bill that they get every month. The Nigerian public wants to be able to control the energy that they use. If you have a prepaid meter, you control. You are the one that determines how much you spend every month. If this is done successfully, which I believe it would, because the regulator and the discos have had several deliberations. We've had several deliberations with the meter asset provider. There's been a huge deliberation and discussion and processes just to ensure that this works. Once that works, it improves customer experience. It improves the complaints that we get from customers about my bill is not correct, I don't trust the meter. People can easily get meters now, unlike before when the discos could not. It's just going to be something that I'm looking forward to it. I'm very excited about it. And Ikeda Electric is offering utmost support to the maps that we, have, or the maps that have been approved by the regulator.